Today I'm going to let you in on some tips for first-time homebuyers, plus a couple additional ones on how to make a solid offer. If this is something you're interested in, then just keep watching. We're getting started right now. Hi everyone, my name is Maria Piccioni and I'm a real estate agent in Rochester, Rochester Hills, Oakland Township, and the surrounding communities in Southeast Michigan. And today I'm going to walk you through what you can expect being a first-time homebuyer and include a bunch of tips that will help you through the process. So, before I get started, if this is your first time here, make sure to hit that subscribe button so that you never miss an update. I put out new videos every week. Also use the link in the information box below to download your free home buyer's guide. So let's get started. If you're starting to think about buying a home, it is a-okay to start looking online for ideas. Where you'd like to live, what kind of houses you're interested in, how much houses cost in your desired area, etc. Even checking out some open houses or new model construction homes is a great way to get the ball rolling. But once you're serious about purchasing your first home, it's time to get serious about your finances. Tip number one, get a pre-approval. Start by meeting with a mortgage lender or financial institution to discuss your financial situation. If you're not sure, ask a trusted real estate professional for a recommendation. Real estate agents work with many different lenders and can help point you in the right direction. Initially, a lender will ask you some basic questions about your finances. They can provide you with pre-qualification, which shows you how much financing you might be able to get qualified. Then, when you're ready to commit, you'll go a step further by getting a pre-approval. A pre-approval is essential before you start looking at houses because it'll tell you exactly how much financing you've gotten approved. Be prepared to provide income statements, employment, assets, and debts. If you're self-employed, or depending on how you get paid, your lender may require additional documents. Having a pre-approval is a must-have when you want to offer to purchase a house. Most sellers will not accept an offer to purchase from a buyer without a pre-approval, even if they have a pre-qualification. A pre-approval is much more involved than a pre-qualification. The buyer has submitted all of their financials and the lender has made a conditional commitment in writing. Tip number two, hire a real estate professional and get house hunting. Now that you've been pre-approved, it's finally time to start house hunting. The fun part, although let's be honest, it can be a little stressful at times, but working with a real estate professional can help remove a lot of the first-time homebuyer nerves. When selecting a real estate agent, make sure you're working with someone professional and who you trust. It's a bonus if you enjoy working together because you'll be spending a lot of time together in the upcoming weeks. Did you know that there is no cost to hire a real estate agent to help you buy your house? Buyer's agents get paid by the listing agent, which is the real estate agent that represents the seller. So, as you begin looking at houses, don't be afraid to ask your real estate agent any questions you may have. Often, they've already helped other buyers just like you with the same concerns. If not, they'll know who to get you the answers you need. Tip number three, prioritize. As a first-time home buyer, you may not get everything you want. Try to make a list of must-have versus wants. Sometimes you may think you have to have something, only to realize that something else is more important. Things like paint, light fixtures, and decor are easy upgrades. A real estate agent can be a valuable resource to help you in check along the way. Tip number four, make a solid offer. Making your first offer to purchase can be nerve-wracking, but knowing what to expect can help. Here are some additional tips for first-time homebuyers to consider when putting in an offer. Put in your best offer up front. You won't likely have the chance to submit a better offer. Have cash set aside for additional expenses like the earnest money deposit and home inspection. And make sure to include any fixtures like drapery, shelving, or mirrors in their purchase agreement if you want those to come with the house. And lastly, if it's a seller's market, find out via your real estate agent if there's anything you can do to help sweeten the pot to get your offer accepted. Once your offer gets accepted, Congratulations! You're well on your way to becoming a first-time homebuyer. During this time, you'll be getting your earnest money submitted, completing home inspections, and ordering an appraisal. But don't worry, your real estate agent and the lender will help you with all of this. Tip number 5, stay in touch with the lender. You'll also be in contact with your lender throughout this entire process. They'll be working on getting all of the details of your loan finalized. Now, considering that everything goes well, including the home inspection and the appraisal, the loan will be finalized in underwriting. You'll receive a clear to close. You now have the green light to schedule a closing. The house is almost yours. Tip number 6, don't make any big purchases. Don't run out and start buying any large appliance purchases just yet. Lenders can and often do run your credit at the very last minute. If you have any large purchases racked up on your credit card, it may throw off your debt to income ratio. In return, you'll be ineligible for your loan. Once you've received your clear to close, your real estate agent will schedule a closing. In Michigan, closing happens at the real estate office, title company, or lender's office. You'll need to bring in your cash to close, usually in the form of a cashier's check or wire transfer. It covers down payment and any other additional closing costs. The title company will have a bunch of paperwork for you to sign. Most of what you will be signing will be from the lender, confirming that you are getting a loan, that you agree to pay back the loan, and that you acknowledge that if you don't pay the loan, you could lose the house. Yikes! The rest of the paperwork will be signed by signing over the deed from the seller to you. If you're paying cash, you'll have far less paperwork to sign. Tip number 7, get ready to celebrate. You'll then get the keys, assuming that you're getting immediate occupancy and the sellers won't be leasing back the property. Congratulations are now in order. You are officially a first-time homebuyer. If you have any more first-time homebuyer questions, let us know. We are always here as a resource for you. Thank you, and I'll see you soon.